Hello, I'm Chris Menard. I have a great video today. I'm going to discuss what is the difference between the break-even versus the margin of safety. This question came from one of my YouTube subscribers. I've already created two videos on the break-even point. Both will be down below. One covers just one product figuring out the break-even, but then I did a break-even analysis chart on that. The second video also came from that video. Someone said, we only did one product. In real life, we have multiple products. So I did break-even analysis with multiple products. That video is also got a link down below. So the break-even point, I've got to figure that out prior to doing the margin of safety. You just have to. The break-even point is where your net income is zero. You're not making money. You're not losing money. You're breaking even. Break even is part of cost, volume, profit analysis. Safety margin is the difference between what you have budgeted versus your break even. So I'm going to cover this today for both units, dollars, and even a percentage for the margin of safety. So the numbers in here that I'm using for this example, I'm making up. So here we go. But whenever I do a formula, I'll put the formula over in column C. So whatever this is we have, we're going to do it for $40 a unit. Variable cost are direct material, direct labor are examples. So the more volume you do, the higher your total variable cost will be, because they're directly tied into the units. So really, $40 is what people buy it for. It costs us $32 in variable materials and variable cost. So therefore, our contribution margin, basically, what are we really making per each unit after the variable cost? $8. Now, we've got fixed costs. At our plant, that would be our rent. We got to pay for security. We got to pay for insurance for the building. A lot of different fixed costs. They don't change per period. I don't care if the period is a month, a quarter, or a year, whatever you want this to be. I'm going to make that $7,000. Whether we make any units or not, we got to pay that $7,000. So our budgeted units, again, I'm making this up. We believe we're going to do $1,000 a period. So here you go, $40 for every unit, that's what people pay for it, times 1,000, 40,000. Let me go ahead and do some formula text over here for you. I know that's a formula, B1 minus B2, and there's another formula. So here comes our break-even point. Net income is going to be zero, no loss, no profit. Break-even in units is simply, we've got to pay that $7,000 fixed cost every period. What do we actually make per unit to cover that fixed cost? Not $40, $8. So our break-even point in unit is 875 units. If you did 875 times 40, which is what I'm about to do, 875 times 40, there is your break-even point in dollars. So now we've got our break-even point and we know what our budget is. So now you can figure out the margin of safety. Without rows 7 and 8, I can't do it. So I'm going to do the margin of safety in dollars, in a percentage, and in units. So this one's really simple. We budgeted for $40,000. Our break-even point is $35,000. That is the margin of safety in dollars. Whatever you've budgeted to do minus your break-even in dollars, $5,000. So hopefully we make the $40,000. But if we don't, if we did $38,000, we're still within our margin of safety because we're not losing any money. If we did $36,000, we're still okay. If we did $34,000, now we have a net loss because we're below the break-even in dollars. That $5,000 is our safety margin. What is that as a percentage? It's simply the $5,000 divided by your total budgeted. I've already formatted that as a percentage. So that is your 12.5% right there. And then finally, the last item, what is our margin of safety in units? So we already said it's $5,000. Really simple. How many units did we budget for? 1,000 minus what is our break even in units? Again, you see why you have to do the break even first. So 1,000 units minus 875 units is 125 units. That is also a formula. So let me pull that down. So there are your three different margins of safety that I did. I had to do the break-even point first. Break-even, just remember, not making any money, not losing any money. There you go. I hope that answers that question. Couple easy observations. If you can reduce your fixed cost, that always is going to help. Think about yourself personally with your finance. You got your house note, you got your car note, you got your car insurance, you got your homeowners or renters insurance. Those are all fixed costs. The lower, the better. I believe you agree with me on that one here. Also, what else? The lower the fixed cost. Also, the variable cost per unit, the lower off, you're better. I'm making this example up. Let's say we went back and looked at this and said, hey, it's not $32 a unit. It's only $28. By changing this to $28, all these numbers and even percentages get much better. So there it is at $28 right there. Margin of safety in units is now $417. Because the break-even in units went drastically down. I'm gonna go back to 32 to show the difference again. That is it. I don't want to take any more of your valuable time. I appreciate it. Feel free to catch my other two videos on break-even, especially if you need the chart. That is the very first break-even video. And the second break-even again is if you got multiple products. I did what's called a product mix. If you have any comments or questions about this video, please let me know. Have a wonderful day, and as always, feel free to subscribe. Thank you.